Hey guys, welcome back to AX3 Gaming. My name is Alec and welcome back to another episode of Journey of Wrestling. If you guys didn't catch that last episode, unfortunately we forgot to book all of our rivalries for War Games. So make sure to go back and watch that last episode. The entire playlist is linked in the description. And without further ado guys, let's get right back into booking NXT TakeOver War Games. Alright guys, so we got a pretty straightforward card tonight. For the most part. Actually no, it's not very straightforward at all. I don't know why I said that, because we got a big War Games match, which we don't know who's going to be in it, and we don't know what we're going to do with it. So here we are. Maybe we should do a women's War Games match this year, especially since I didn't plan it. We probably can. Who would be in it? Toni Storm. We would go, because Rhea Ripley and Bea Priestley are busy. We just need to find six viable women. Alexa Bliss, Becky Lynch, Peyton Royce, Toni Storm. So there's a good four. Shayna Baszler, and debuting Io Shirai. Not debuting, she debuted a bit ago, but she can be in this. That would be a cool... Actually, let's do that. Let's do a nice women's War Games match here. Let's try it out. So we'll go gimmick here. We'll go War Games. And we will go Toni Storm, Peyton Royce... No, not Bea Priestley. Peyton Royce, Alexa Bliss, Becky Lynch, Shayna Baszler, and Io Shirai. That's a fun little... Shmoop-da-doop. A little bit of alignment boost as well. Awesome. So that'll be able to main event the card tonight. And then, we'll just book all the other feuds normally for now. And we also need to not forget to book the Battle Royal. I don't know if it was last pay-per-view or two pay-per-views ago, but I definitely forgot to book it, and I was really upset. We'll go Adam Cole versus Aleister Black. And that, I guess, will be the I Quit match. And Aleister Black versus Adam Cole is going to be a blow-off as well. That's going to be an I Quit match. Perfect. And then we'll have Bea Priestley versus Rhea Ripley. Yeah, we'll put the tag team match as the elimination, because that's the only one that makes sense. We'll do elimination for the tag match. Beautiful. You know what? And they can have a gimmick as well. Ladder prison. Let's do it. Ladder prison match. I guess that's just a ladder match in a cell, right? That's what I assume it is, just based off the name. Okay, and let's go back to singles here. Big E, Tommaso Ciampa is a normal match. Lee and Orton is a normal match. And then Braun Strowman, Tyler Breeze is actually going to be a tag team match. We'll go 2v2. We'll go Tyler Breeze, Fandango. Versus Braun Strowman and Kurt Angle. Braun Strowman's going through the entire tag team division trying to find a partner that will help him defeat Breezango. But here we go, we'll put that a bit lower because we want that to be, it's a world championship match, be a bigger one. Anything else is blowing off? I believe Bea Priestley and Rhea Ripley is blowing off. Yeah, Bea Priestley and Rhea Ripley is blowing off. And Inner Circle versus the Rock and Rollers. Or I can stretch this out, can I? They'll be at 6.25. If I only do segments with them, they'll be at 6.75. Yeah, we can forcefully stretch this out. Yeah, let's do it. Because I have something specific planned, and it's not really lining up exactly how I wanted it to, but that's fine. We won't add a blow off to that, but Bea Priestley versus Rhea Ripley will get a blow off. And I think that's the only one. And Aleister Black versus Adam Cole, sorry. And then we'll go probably backstage attack then. All the women are going to be in matches though, or in the War Games match, so it'll be hard to put someone there. You want to get Dakota Kai up? She was dropping pretty fast. Oh, Shotzi Blackheart is very over. I guess it's because she's because they're in the stable. Yeah, let's put Shotzi Blackheart. That'll be fun. Try to get her up to the main event. Yeah, and Sonya Deville is way up here with the Battle Royal Championship now. Okay, so we'll go Shotzi Blackheart and Rhea Ripley in a backstage attack. Awesome. And that'll be right after the Women's North American Championship match. New challenger, let's just do that. And then for the North American Championship, yeah, let's have Kurt Angle. That would be pretty cool. Adam Cole versus Kurt Angle feud. Stare down, and we'll go Kurt Angle and... Actually, no, we'll go... You have to click Adam Cole first and Kurt Angle. Adam Cole and Kurt Angle. Add feud, not retirement, new title challenger. Okay, perfect. Awesome. And we need to book the heat promo for Bray Wyatt. Okay, and this is looking like it's our card for tonight, guys. All right, so starting off the show tonight, we're going to have a heat promo for Bray Wyatt. And then we're going to have a tag team match, Breezango versus Kurt Angle and Braun Strowman. And then we're going to have for the Cruiserweight Championship, Big E versus Tommaso Ciampa. For the NXT Tag Team Championships in an elimination match, we're going to have the Archers of Rock and Roll versus the Inner Circle. And then Rhea Ripley versus Bea Priestley is going to have their last match in a ladder prison match for the Women's North American Championship. And then we're going to have a backstage attack between Shotzi Blackheart and Rhea Ripley. And then a North American Championship match for in an I Quit match between Aleister Black and Adam Cole, which is their last match. And then a stare down between Adam Cole and Kurt Angle. And then we're going to have for the World Championship, Randy Orton versus Keith Lee. And then main event, we're going to have our War Games match for the NXT Women's Championship, Io Shirai versus Shayna Baszler versus Becky Lynch versus Alexa Bliss versus Peyton Royce versus Toni Storm. And you think I forgot to book the Battle Royal? And you know what? I almost did. So let's go do that real quick right now before I forget again. Battle Royal, awesome. Booked. Owens is not booked tonight, so Owens can be in the Battle Royal. Okay, who's in the tag team match? We got Jericho and Gibson, so let's get Gargano in there. Big E is busy, Aleister Black is busy, Gibson's busy, Orton's busy, Tony is busy, B Priestley's busy, Jericho's busy, Ricochet can be in there, Rhea Ripley's busy, Walter can be in there, Tommaso Ciampa is busy, Peyton Royce is busy, Bliss is busy, Elias busy, Becky Lynch, Roderick Strong can be in there, Braun Strowman's busy, Kurt Angle's busy, Finn Balor can go in there. Shayna Baszler is busy. Priest is busy. Shirai is busy. Lee is busy. Deville is the champion. Put her in. Breeze and Fandango. Let's put Tyler Breeze in to get him up even more. But we'll put Fandango in. Might as well as well. And we might as well put Braun Strowman in then. And then Kurt Angle too. Okay. We'll put Bray Wyatt in. Ember Moon. Miro. Killian Dane. Hardy. Kushida. Kyle O'Reilly, Dakota Kai, Austin Theory, Shotzi Blackheart, Lacey Evans, Tay Conchi, Chad Gable, Murphy, and Lana. All right. And that is our Battle Royal. We got a 26-person Battle Royal here. Got negative alignment for that as usual, but for the Battle Royal Championship. And we got this other feud in here. I loved you. All right, and that is our card for tonight, guys. Let me put the Heat promo before, and let's get into it. NXT presents NXT TakeOver War Games live tonight in front of a fully packed audience. Fan interest high for the event, which is headlined by the women and the women's championship in a War Games match. I'm not going to read all those names. One of the most anticipated matches of the night is Adam Cole versus Aleister Black for the North American Championship in an I Quit match. Other matches that fan buzzing include Inner Circle versus Archers of Rock and Roll for the Tag Team Championships, an elimination match, and Rhea Ripley versus Bea Priestley for the Women's North American Championship in a ladder prison match. Continue to see your predictions for the event. We got an all-women's poster here because they're all in the big War Games match tonight, so that's awesome to see. And let's get into the predictions, not the card. So starting off, they predict that Kevin Owens will win the Battle Royal Championship, that Kurt Angle and Braun Strowman will win via cheating, that there's a 70% chance that Tommaso Ciampa will win and 30% chance that Big E will win. They predict that the Inner Circle will retain, Rhea Ripley will retain, Adam Cole will retain, Randy Orton will retain, and Becky Lynch will retain. Let's see how they did. Bray Wyatt is in a ring for a promo. Bray Wyatt talked about being better than every person in the crowd. Okay, 4 3/3 stars as usual. Just chugging along on that Heat promo. Hopefully we get there soon. We're almost there. Let's continue on. We got the Battle Royal Championship here. We got three different champions in this match, but we will have Sonya Deville once again retain her Battle Royal Championship here. Whoa. 4.5 stars. Since when? What happened this time, everybody? Usually it's at least 5 stars, if not like 5.25, 5.5. Maybe because I had freaking Lana in there, who's a lower mid-carder. I don't know what happened this time, but that's still like 4.5 stars is not a big deal, but whatever. Walter became the face of the company. Battle Royal increased for the event. Murphy starting it over with the fans. Fandango's dancer gimmick progressed. Tay Conchi's gimmick progressed. Murphy's gimmick progress. Everyone's gimmick progress. Okay, good. Loving to see that. Prestige is continuing on. Battle Royal Championship is getting some more prestige there. Let's keep it going. Got Breezango versus Kurt Angle and Braun Strowman. We'll have Breezango pick up another huge tag team victory here with a 4 3/4 star, beating out the Battle Royal for the first time ever. Breezango and Kurt Angle and Braun Strowman put on a hot match, boosting their overness by 4%. And that is all there. Let's keep it going. Tommaso Ciampa and Big E here. No, I gotta stop doing finishes. I learned to stop doing finishes. Now I'm tempted to do them again, but I don't want Big E to lose, but I don't want him to win either. Let's have Tommaso Ciampa pick up the victory. 11 points to the feud. Hey, 5.5 stars. Cool spots, gave an extra half star. Awesome. 7 more points to the feud. Nothing about Big E's happiness, so that's good. How happy is he right now, actually? Oh, he's at 80% now? Okay, so screw this. He's definitely not winning this then. I don't know what happened, but he's at 80%. Okay. Tag Team Championships, prove yourself feud here. We're going to have once again an inner circle picking up the victory, 9 to both, and a 5-star match. Okay, 9 more points to the feud. Hot match there. Elimination match increase for the event. Let's keep it going. Rhea Ripley versus Bea Priestley for the Women's North American Championship. Let's have Rhea Ripley pick up the victory here. Wow, 5.25 stars, 6 more points to the feud, and that is the blow off to their big feud there. Their feud blew off at 4.75 stars, ladder prison increase for this event. Cool, let's keep it going. Shotzi Blackheart is going to attack Rhea Ripley backstage, starting a new rivalry there. 5 stars, okay, not bad. Good start there, so I'm liking to see that. Yeah, and why is her alignment down? One's a face and one's a heel. That's perfect alignment. Anyway, let's keep it going. Aleister Black versus Adam Cole, North American Championship. We're going to have Adam Cole retain here. Wow, in a 5.75 star match. Almost 6 stars there. Good work, everybody. Aleister Black and Adam Cole put on a hot match. Greatest wrestler feud between Adam Cole and Aleister Black. Blew off at 5 stars. An I Quit increase for the event. All positive results here. Let's keep it going. Adam Cole and Kurt Angle stare each other down. The title laying the mat between them. Adam Cole points his finger at Kurt Angle, dares him to make a move. Referee ended the ring and broke both wrestlers apart, both holding the stairs at each other. 5 stars, 63 point for you to start off. Awesome. And no other news down here. Let's keep it going. We got for the NXT Championship here, we got Randy Orton versus Keith Lee. No finish on this. We're just gonna have Keith Lee win the World Championship, and that gave him a huge boost there. Jesus. Randy Orton got a little bit of negative, but we got a new world champion. Extra half star for being full of action, and we got a 5.25 star match. Let's go. 6 more points to the feud. That's great. Keith Lee is on his way to becoming the face of the company. Great. No other news down here, but we do have a new world champion now. He might have been released by WWE, but he is the world champion here in my universe. Let's keep it going. And we have the Women's War Games match here. A huge match going down between 6 of the best women on our roster and the debuting Io Shirai. I know she's like been on some stuff. I don't know if she's really had a match yet. Has she had a match? I think she's done a couple promos or something. I don't know. But anyway, Becky Lynch will retain her women's championship. Wow, everyone went down quite a bit. But Becky Lynch will retain. Okay, so 5.5 stars. So that's been our best one. So I guess the feuds really don't make a difference then in this War Games match. Or maybe they knew what I was doing, so they pulled down my stars for just making feuds for the War Games match. But that's awesome. That was a great match. Okay, cool. No news. War Games match increase for the event. And Keith Lee's on a way of coming face the company. I don't know if I read that earlier. But yeah, that is our card for tonight, guys. I think we got above 5 star. We had a lot of matches, or a decent amount of matches above 5 stars. And the others were either at 5 stars or slightly lower. Right here, and then the heat promo, as always, will kind of pull down our stars, but I think we still got above a 5-star show here. Yeah, 5.25, let's go. So hopefully we will pull a decent amount of fans with that. Let's see how we did. We gained 34,000 fans with a 5.25 star. AEW lost 10,000 fans with a 5-star. New Japan lost 7,000 with a 5-star. SmackDown lost 10,000 with a 5-star. Stardom gained only 500 fans with a 5.5-star, and TLC for Raw lost 8,000 fans with a 4.25 star. Let's see what we got in the news. The top headline, Tyler Breeze gets over. That's awesome. Keith Lee crowned new champion, match of the year contender for the War Games match. Fantastic match between Randy Orton and Keith Lee. Aleister Black and Adam Cole had a match of the year contender. Classic match between Rhea Ripley and Bea Priestley. Tag Team Championship match was great. Classic match between Big E and Tommaso Ciampa. And fantastic match between Breezango, Kurt Angle, and Braun Strowman. My hiccups are all over the place. Let's see what happened. Okay, Isaiah Swerve Scott was accepted. Yearly negotiations are coming up. Available call-ups coming out. Goal review. Oh, yeah, we got some new goals coming. And let's see. Well, we only have 3 emails. We usually have like 7. I need a fresh start. Thanks for signing me. We got Isaiah Swerve Scott on the roster now. Good talk with Big E. Okay, Big E is happy. He's got an extra 15% now. Managed successfully recruit EC3, and now he's available to recruit on our, or get onto our roster. Let's see Big E's happiness now. He's nowhere near to being upset anymore, right? Yeah, he's 85%. Okay, cool. So we don't have to worry about him leaving anytime soon. He was all the way down at 29% and dissatisfied, so that's good now. I didn't mean to go to roster. I wanted to go to Indies. So we got Ruaka, Jay Long, or EC3. Let's get an EC3. Good, decent pop, good charisma, not bad work rate. Overness is a bit low. We'll get that up though. Control your narrative is a gimmick. Okay, we'll negotiate with him. 250. Let's make this quick. I got places to be. You're not starting hot, EC3. Okay, 275. There you go. Join our roster. Thanks for stopping by. Oh my god, my money is low. Okay, I need to get my money up. All right, so that's good. Who do we want to try to pick up this week? Oh, Pete Dunne? Oh, how the heck did Pete Dunne get on here? And we got Alexander Wolf. Okay, no, chill. We're getting Pete Dunne. I don't freaking care. His work rate is 4. His charisma is 3. His pop is high. Who released Pete Dunne? Oh my god, recruit. Please recruit him. Oh my god, my money's going to be too low. What if I can't get him? Okay, I need to get my money up to get Pete Dunne. Okay, we want Pete Dunne on our roster. Jesus Christ. Who the hell would release Pete Dunne at a time like this? Okay, so we got 3 up here. What else do we have to do? We got to reassure someone. So let's go to our roster. Isaiah Scott is a lower mid carder as well. Is Billy Kay upset that she's injured? No, she's happy about being injured. Lacey Evans? No, 100%. Dude, I haven't even found anyone like under 85 yet. 83. Let's see if I can reassure Bray Wyatt. No, it's already too high. It has to be below 80. Orton's probably... Oh, Orton's okay. Orton's at 76, which is kind of weird. I guess because he just lost the world championship. But whatever. Okay, he's reassuring Randy Orton now. That's good. Okay, finally, we found someone to reassure. So next couple episodes, we're really going to try to push hard for Pete Dunne. We really want to get him on our roster. He's already up very high. Billie Kay is almost on her way back. Bianca Belair is a bit farther, but she's on her way. We got Isaiah Swerve Scott on the roster now. Keith Lee, new world champion. We got a huge War Games match. Fans are going up. Things are looking good. And we got NXT TakeOver The End in 2 shows here after booking 2 more weeks of NXT. Things are looking great, guys. We got the new goals coming up really soon. So I'm very excited to see what kind of goals he or Triple H gives us this time. And see if they'll be even remotely challenging, because last year we were able to finish it, I think, in the first like couple months. So hopefully this one will be a bit tougher, and we'll try to get those goals done once again. So thank you so much for stopping by, guys. Hope you did enjoy this episode. If you did, make sure to hit that like button. It does help me out a lot. Also, right underneath me here, there is a subscribe button if you guys want to click that to get notified whenever I release a video so you do not miss one. And then over on the right, we got some more videos if you guys want to keep watching. Thanks so much, guys.